everyone, it's the time of the day when we tell you about everything that's buzzing in the startup space. I'm Priya Sheth and a very warm welcome to all of you to the Daily Dispatch. Now, the three companies that I'm going to be talking about today include Zomato, Flipkart, as well as Upgrad. And here's why these companies are in news today. Now, in one of the most significant and pivotal moments in Indian tech startup history, food delivery platform Zomato has kicked off its IPO today. Now, the company has already raised about 4,200 crore rupees from 186 anchor investors in the pre-IPO round, and the fresh funds raised through the anchor investors are almost 45% of the total issue size in the IPO. Well, the second company that we're talking about today is Flipkart. Today, after Flipkart received about $3.6 billion in funding from global investors, the Walmart-owned company has decided to use this funding for an ESOPs buyback worth 600 crore rupees. And this current round will take the valuation to about $37.6 billion. This comes as Flipkart prepares for its public listing in the US in the coming year. Well, moving on to the third headline of the day, it's related to higher education platform Upgrad. Now, Singaporean investment giant Temasek Holdings as well as World Bank Arm IFC have infused an additional 220 crore rupees into Upgrad, and the investment giants infused this amount by buying out ESOPs from around 37 employees. Well, moving on to our second segment, I have with me someone who has been in the languages space, specifically with EdTech. I have with me Devki Agarwal from Instruco. Thank you very much, Devki, for joining us today on the Daily Dispatch. I want to begin by asking you about the last couple of months. People have been at home. EdTech has really taken off in a big way. What's the kind of growth that you've seen?
So I think obviously there's been a growth in EdTech over the last 1 year. We've seen a lot of people move online, very comfortably so as well. Initially, of course, you know, all the schools started moving online and now parents have just got used to online classes. I think, you know, we've actually completed over 300,000 minutes of lessons over the last couple of months. We've seen over 2,000 people join our platform and who are paying customers who are doing lessons with us. So, you know, this has been a tremendous growth that we have achieved within 6 months since December. So I think the fact that, you know, online is accessible to anyone, everyone is just has made it very, very easy for people to be on the platform from anywhere in the world and choose, you know, their timings, their lessons, everything.
Right. You know, in terms of the kind of products available on your website, I wanted to understand what would be the core categories that are driving this kind of growth and where are you seeing pockets of traction?
Yeah, so see, as we all know, you know, the most important form of communication is language, right? I mean, that is the form of communication. And if you've seen the trend over the few over the last few years, India has always been a very, very academic market. Having said that, you know, people in India mostly end up focusing on STEM subjects. And when I say STEM, I basically mean, you know, math, science, etc. And one problem they face is when, you know, they're taking interviews or not being able to communicate effectively, right? So we have started language classes, which not just helps them with English, but also learning any kind of language because, you know, obviously the world has come closer. People are moving to different parts of the world to work. People have offices all over the world and having, you know, being able to speak other languages gives you an edge over most people, one. And two, you know, the kind of the products we have, you know, we have English, Hindi, French, Spanish, Mandarin, German. We also teach public speaking and creative writing. These are all very specialized ways of learning because we teach through storytelling methods. We have, you know, we focus a lot on life skills as well. So everything has to do with things you will actually use and not just something theoretical, which is not going to come to use in your practical life, right? Our teachers are very, very highly trained, all certified. We teach through a storytelling methodology, which essentially enables children to learn in a better way and also be able to retain the information because of the story that they have heard, right? So everything is very interactive. We focus a lot on critical thinking and emotional intelligence because I think that's one thing, again, that has not been given that much importance to. And if you see the NEP 2020, It actually talks about critical thinking, emotional intelligence, storytelling methods, you know, making it very interactive, personalized, tailoring lessons based on the child's development. And that's essentially what Instruco is doing, you know. All our content has actually been created by experts from University of Oxford. Our teachers are certified, both, you know, we have options of native speakers as well as teachers from India. So, you know, parents have that global exposure and access to essentially any teacher they want from any part of the world. And you know, just all online using great content.
Give us an estimation as to how many students are from India and how many students are from overseas, if there's a breakup in terms of percentage that you can share.
So I would say basically we have over 85% of, around 85% from India and the rest overseas. And that's partly because, you know, we've grown a lot through word of mouth, right? We did onboard Kareena Kapoor, you know, because we have people like her whose kids are doing lessons with us from the industry as well in India. We have people abroad. But what's typically happened is that our focus is on the Indian market at the moment. And as a result of word of mouth, we have gone to different parts of the world, right? We have not really actively marketed anywhere. We have marketed mainly in India. And so that has been our focus from the very beginning.
In terms of collaborations, I wanted to understand, would you be collaborating with schools to bring to them this kind of platform or an EdTech platform? Or how would you really reach out to people out there who want to learn a new language, for instance?
Yeah, so we have two models, right? One is B2C, which is obviously where people come directly to our website and sign up with us. And one is B2B, which is where schools, you know, have collaborated with us. We're working with MS Dhoni School in Bangalore, which we know Instruco is part of their curriculum. So we are doing lessons for them for both English as well as other languages with teachers from India and the UK, right? So we have both options where the students of MS Dhoni School take classes with us on a weekly basis. And then we have another model where, you know, we train their teachers as well to use our content. So even if you don't want live classes, you can get access to our content, which is very much in sync with the curriculum in India, just more academic and more technical, based on, you know, the Oxford Cambridge curriculum. And then they can use that content and teach the students in their own school. We also recently partnered with Literacy India, which has educated over 6 million learners from underprivileged backgrounds. And we conduct classes with them as well once a week.
Going forward in 2021, I wanted to understand what kind of products are on the anvil. Is there something that you're looking at launching in terms of an extension to the services that you already offer?
Yeah, so I think there are lots of interesting, exciting things coming up. I think we are planning a lot of things. We are in the process of building, bringing more technology-based learning as well. And there are a bunch of other products that we are launching, you know, for which we will do press announcements as and when we launch them. We are tying up with more international schools. We tied up with Eton X, which is Eton College's offshoot, and we provide Eton X's content to students in India. So similarly, we're tying up with other international schools where parents actually have access to great schools across the world, but online at a very low cost, but get certified by these schools, which actually help their children get into top universities, you know, help them also build the skills that are required, right? So we are doing multiple partnerships, multiple product launches in the next 6 months.
I believe you raised some pre-Series A money some time back. Wanted to understand what kind of fundraise plans do you have, considering that you're looking at some sort of expansion going forward?
Yeah, so we actually are closing our pre-Series A, which is a continuation of the round we raised, in the next 1 week. We're closing a substantial amount, you know, in 6 months since we've started the company. And I think in the next 6 months, we will be raising a Series A round. We have been approached by multiple venture capitalists, private equities, and we will be closing our Series A in the next six to eight months.
Final question, Devki, before I let you go on revenue and growth for the end of FY21. What kind of at the end of FY22? What kind of revenue targets do you have? And in terms of profitability, how far are you from profitability?
Profitability, of course, depends on our scalability. So as much as we pump in, will totally depend on what we're looking at. At the moment, while we work on a very different model where our margins are high and, we would be profitable if depending on how much we're spending on marketing, right? So I think it's pretty much dependent on that. Our conversion rates are very, very high. So our conversion rates, from a trial class to a package is 80%. So we have very high renewal rates as well. So I think most parents who end up staying on our platform, purchase at least 2 to 3 packages on our platform. Our average order value size is very high as well. So, I think in terms of the business model, the parents have to pay for the classes before they start and do the classes with us. So we're not really, with all of that, I think the growth is tremendous and there's a lot of potential because with us launching different products, a parent is buying multiple things with us. It's not just one language or one product, right? So it's multiple languages that the parents are purchasing with us.
All right, Devki, thank you so much for joining us today. And it's really been a pleasure to speak with you. Thank you so much for being a part of the Devki.
Thank you.
Well, it's time now to wrap up this edition of the Devki Dispatch. I'll catch you tomorrow at 5 p.m. Goodbye and stay safe.